I'm working with Marabu's Textile and Textile Plus paints today. Textile is transparent while Textile Plus is opaque for use on dark surfaces where it provides more coverage. Don't dismiss them as not your thing if you're not a fabric person. As you'll see, they work beautifully on paper and other porous surfaces, and the extended open time allows for some interesting creative options. Don't let the word textile in the name of these paints fool you into thinking that they're not for you, that they're not suitable for the kinds of things that we do as paper people, where we work on watercolor paper or Bristol paper in an art journal to create a card, maybe on a canvas, primed canvas or not. All of the things that I'm going to show you today, primarily on paper, certainly are transferable for work on fabric, and the techniques work virtually identically. So Textile Plus is a heavy-bodied or heavier-bodied paint that's, well, you can feel the difference. I'm going to demo finger painting on a Bristol art card just to show you how this product goes on, and you'll definitely feel the difference. You'll feel what I'm going to, which is that the Textile Plus has it's thicker bodied, it's meant to be opaque for work on dark surfaces. So here's a couple of examples. This and this are both Textile Plus. Now this is the first attempt I made at using the Textile Plus on this dark surface with this particular stencil of ours. It's endless. So the process is put paint on the plate, manipulate the paint with the stencil by putting the stencil down, putting paper down and pressing through the openings to lift some of the paint off the plate, removing the stencil and pulling the print. That's the process I followed for both of these. Now I have a tendency to be heavy-handed with paint when I'm applying it to create a monoprint, so one of the things that I've tried to do is back off a little bit and not use so much paint. So interestingly enough, even though I didn't use a ton of paint, both of these colors show really well. Obviously you have one lighter and one darker here, but show really well. This is a dark green batik fabric, and it works. It works even better when you move away from being very judicious about how much paint you apply, and you put on a layer that's a little bit thicker, so you can see that you get variations here. Now this was done, let's slide this out of the way, this was done through a stencil on, this is just a piece of scrapbook paper, it's random, all I did was choose it so that it was dark enough that I could point out that the Textile Plus will cover the pattern. This was applied with a mini ink blending tool and the foam with a couple of different colors through one of our stencils. And you can see that there's really good coverage. Now I will tell you that I find that I get better coverage if I tap like this when I'm applying the paint. I feel like I get heavier coats and I get more coverage. Now if you are not as worried about that and you're simply using the color because you like it, then you can kind of back off to any technique that you enjoy. So here's the thing, these are fabric paints. Now I did this yesterday. You can see how soft and pliable this foam remains, but you can also see that it's dry. I'm not rubbing any of the paint off on my fingers. The paint when it dries makes virtually no change to the hand of the fabric, and for people who are going to work on fabric, that's actually pretty important. You don't want your fabric when you get through, for example, when you pull a print like this through a gel press plate, you don't want this to be as stiff as a board. Now, because I used a fair amount of paint, I can feel it ever so slightly on here, but the difference is that this doesn't feel like it's been laminated because it's so stiff from the paint, and that's really important. As I mentioned in the opening, one of the things that I discovered, and I spent 4 full days working with these two paints when we were at the American Quilter Society show in Grand Rapids, Michigan back in August of 2017, and I spent 4 days straight working with this paint and the shimmer sprays and the fashion sprays, and one of the things that I learned was, see this background here? This is paint that was left on a stencil. There's that extended open time that allows you to do some really interesting things. I'm going to show you first, I'm just going to bring in, this is one of Strathmore's 4x4 Bristol art tiles. I'm just going to quickly bring in 3 colors. I want to show you that you can finger paint this on. You can do the same stuff with this paint that you do with every other paint. So the purple is Textile Plus, the other two are both Textile. I'm actually just going to work out of the cover. There's more than enough paint in there. So this is Textile. You can see that it's transparent. You can see when I put it on that I'm not getting super dark coverage. That's the nature of a transparent paint, so that's what you're going to get. This darker color is also transparent, so again, that's way too much. I'm going to tap some of it off, and I'm just going to start applying it here. One of the things that I found very interesting, and when I played with this on paper once I got home, is when I had an opportunity to really use it kind of the way that I ordinarily would. So let's just wipe this up for 1 second. One of the things that I found really interesting is that when this paint dries, It dries to a nice, smooth, matte surface. These are Pitt pens. This is a super fine in black, and you can see how fine the detail is. There's no problem writing over these paints at all, nothing whatsoever. They're just really good to work with. So now I'm going to pick up some of the Textile Plus, and you can see already the difference. You can see that my finger, as I lift and dip, actually makes impressions in the paint and it will hold. Well, that's because it's a much heavier bodied paint, and I can certainly feel it when I start to apply it with my fingers. It has an entirely different feel. And so when you're thinking that you might need some extra coverage, then the Textile Plus is a really good option. If you're just playing with color for the sake of color, then you can pretty much plan on using them interchangeably. So I'm going to grab a gel press plate. I want to show you printing. I'm going to show you how I did this, how I got this wonderful background and then sprayed through the stencil to get the design, and then I'm going to show you how, but I'm actually going to show you how to do it on paper instead of on fabric. I've chosen two colors. In this case, I have Textile in cherry red and I have Textile Plus in orange red. These make a really nice combination, and then I'm going to spray through them using two of the fashion sprays. I have Shimmer Reseda and Shimmer Aquamarine. You'll remember that there's a mixing ball in these. You can hear it moving around in there. You'll want to use them, or you use that so by shaking them so that you get that pigment up and moving around. So let's start with these two colors. This is our leaf specimen stencil, and I actually have a piece of Kona cotton that I'm going to print on. For what I want to show you, it's the paint that remains on the stencil that I'm going to print on a piece of paper that matters. That's the part of the technique that I'm interested in showing you, because it demonstrates the open time which on this paint, which is really, really important, and it's a really nice advantage. Some acrylic paints dry so fast that you almost don't get time to pull the print unless you layer the paint on reasonably heavily. So I'm going to put a little bit of both colors out on my nonstick craft sheet, on my gel press plate. Now, in this case, I've got more of the orange, which is fine. I'm just going to brayer them across so that I end up with more or less an ombre. In fact, this is an 8x10 gel press plate. Not sure if I mentioned that, but it's a good size plate, and I need to put out enough paint so I get coverage over the entire thing. I'm just going to come back and kind of get that red blended in. As you brayer, you'll also be able to feel the difference between the Textile and the Textile Plus. One is thicker than the other, so it definitely is going to move quite a bit differently. So this is just a piece of printer paper. All I want to do is manipulate the paint. When I think about creating a print with a gel press plate, to me it's three steps. Apply paint to the surface, manipulate the paint, and then pull the print. So now that I've manipulated the paint, and here's what's important. See all that paint that's on the back? When I come back to it, you're going to notice that it's still shiny, and that's going to matter because it means that it's still wet. So I've got my piece of Kona cotton. I'm just going to lay it out here and go ahead and pull the print. Now, when you work with fabric on a gel press plate, I found that there's often not much in the way of, again, really pretty, really nice colors. Super interesting print, the basis for something else. There's really generally not enough paint left to go ahead and create a ghost print, but what you get instead is this. So I have a piece of, this is just 90-pound watercolor paper. I'm going to come along, I'm going to apply this, let's get the string from the fabric out of there. I'm going to apply this shiny side down, which means I'm going to put the wet part of the paint, or the wet paint that's on the back of the stencil, against that paper, and I'm going to press so that I get a print, and I'm going to get, obviously, the negative of this stencil. With that done, before I do anything else, I'm going to bring in my two shimmer colors, my fashion shimmer colors, and then I'm going to go ahead and spritz through the openings of this stencil. Okay, so this is a brand new bottle of the green, which, there we go, I hadn't actually started to use yet. Takes a moment for that liquid to come up through the pickup tube and to start to come out the spray head. Let's just put a little bit more of the green on. I don't want to overdo it, but I do want to get coverage through everything. So before I do anything else, I'm just going to pick this up and kind of wipe up so that I'm not working in a wet spot here, because I'll have paint everywhere. Okay, so here's this, and off it comes. And how awesome is that? you get that fabulous orange and red background. You have that complementary color thing going on. Orange and red tend to be across the color, well, they don't tend to be, they are across the color wheel from green and blue. And so you get all this wonderful color, all of this incredible patterning, and you saw how easy it was. I mean, it takes virtually no effort at all. Now I can see, because this is starting to dry, the shimmer is starting to become evident. If I hold this up, you can see it too. So that just makes this even better, and who knew that that was possible, but it absolutely is. And then the other option here, which I'm not going to do, but I'm going to bring the original one back in to show you, and let's slide this out of the way. The other option is to then come in with the fashion liner, go ahead and outline your leaves, and in my case, I used one of the shimmer colors. You can see it really glimmering, and then I used the same thing to put some dots on the leaves. Suddenly you have this wonderful print that started off with just a bunch of leaves and suddenly becomes so, so much more. So maybe you're thinking you're really not a fabric person. Okay, I get that. This is a piece of Kona cotton, and I love this particular print. It was done the same way, using very similar colors to the technique I showed you a moment ago. So okay, you're thinking you're really never going to pick up a piece of fabric and use this. What about a piece of sticky back canvas? That's what this is. This is the natural color from Ranger. They make natural, and they make one that's more white. It's not bleached white, but it's much whiter than this. So this is just a piece of canvas fabric that is adhesive back, and it's got this backing paper on it. You do what you do with it. You cut it, or you use it the whole sheet. You peel it off, and you apply it however you do, and the adhesive is already built in. So let's say, for the sake of argument, now you can imagine yourself using this instead. So let me show you how I did this particular print. I'm going to work with our flower blossom stencil. This time I have the same red-orange in the Textile Plus, and this is Reseda in the Textile. I'm going to put color out on the plate, and I'm going to go ahead and brayer them separately, though, for all intents and purposes, because I don't want them to mix. I'm liable to end up with a muddy color in the middle. I'm going to get a little bit, but not a ton of mixing. So I'm just going to do this one at a time. Off to the side, I have paper that I'm brayering off the color onto, just to make it easy to clean up here as I go along. So with the green mostly done, I'm going to brayer off the excess color, and then I'll come back in and I'll do the orange. I am going to let these blend just the tiniest bit in the center, not too much, because it won't be a very pretty color. Actually, that's a little more blending than I imagined, but I think it's fine. All right, so we'll roll that off. So first step is to put the stencil down and then grab a piece of paper and pick up the color through the openings. This is the manipulate the paint stage of the game, as it were. And the openings on this are kind of small and narrow, so I am going to spend a moment and just go ahead and pull as much of that through as possible. I might grab another piece of paper and do the same thing again. First, I've got to put my hands on another piece of paper. This is actually two, but that's fine. I am going to print this on a piece of Kona cotton because I can imagine lots of ways to use it, and so that's my plan. And you can see I've picked up, well, first of all, there's a thread from a fabric on there. So I am going to pick up some more because I do want this to be very noticeable. I want that print to be very obvious. So I'm going to take this off, and again, I've got all that painty goodness on the back. That's face up, wet side up, off to the side. I'll grab a piece of Kona cotton. I'm just going to remove the strings because if they get in the way, they will print and it alters the actual print that you get. I'm just going to lay this on here. Whoops. Well, that's the reason you should be ironing your fabric. I guess it's one of those do as I say, not as I do kind of things. Okay, so here's my print. That's the start of something really wonderful. Let me put that off to the side. Let's move the plate out of the way. And I'm going to bring the stencil back, obviously, that has, let me just wipe that up, that has all this wet paint on it. So now I'm going to grab a paper towel and just clean my fingers off. Now I'm going to take a piece of sticky back canvas, and I'm actually going to press it right on here with the canvas side to the wet paint part side. And I'm going to rub that really hard with my hands. I want to get as much color transferring as possible. Because I wasn't stingy with the paint when I applied it to the gel press plate, there's actually enough on there to work with. So now what I'm going to do, and the nice thing is that the paint really helps hold the stencil tight to the sticky back canvas. I've got three colors. I've got Reseda and Aquamarine again, and Rose Pink, all in the shimmer sprays. So let's come in with some of the Aquamarine. Is that? Yes, it's Aquamarine. use a little bit of the rose pink. So obviously where these colors overlap, I'm going to get some purple. And where the, I'm going to bring in the Reseda next. And where the green and the pink overlap, I'm going to get something a little bit muddier, but I actually don't mind that in some cases. I think it's kind of an interesting look. All right, so lots of color still on here. Before I do anything else, I'm going to take a second piece of sticky back canvas, and I'm going to lay it face down into all of that juicy goodness that's on here so I don't waste any of it. I'll print as much of that as possible. Trying to keep my hands somewhat clean. I'm actually going to pick this whole sandwich up, grab my paper towel, and just wipe up so I'm not in a mess here. All right, so first things first, let's look to see what I printed off the front of that stencil. And how awesome is that? I love these colors. I love working on fabric like this, whether you're working on sticky back canvas or you're working on something like the Kona Cotton. And then when I pick this up, now I have the color that was left on the back of the stencil, as well as what I spritzed through the openings. So again, you've got self-adhesive canvas that you can cut up, you can use as it is, whether you work on it, let's say, on the cover of a journal, or you wrap the spine of a journal. There's lots of different ways that you can use this, and with the adhesive built in, it's super simple. The final technique for today is stamping with Textile and Textile Plus. Now, I can do this on paper or I can do it on fabric. If I'm going to do it on paper, one of the things that I've discovered is that the paint pretty much stays put. Now, if you rub it, you'll peel the paper and you'll probably remove it. But unlike fabric, where you do have to heat set, you don't on paper, and I'll show you that in a second. So I have one of our Doodle Flower stamps. This is a Bristol Artist Tile from Strathmore. This is the black textile. I happen to have it out and not the Textile Plus, but it works the same way regardless. So I'm just going to ink up. This is a mini ink blending tool with a foam on it. I'm just going to ink up this stamp and then go ahead and transfer the image. Just want to be certain that you get complete coverage, and then you go ahead and you press. Now, stamping with paint is slightly different than stamping with an ink from an ink pad, primarily because you tend to get a little bit more paint on there than you do with an ink, with an ink pad. So you don't want to push too hard, because otherwise you'll find that it slides around. It'll slip and you'll end up with a smear. But very straightforward. So I like to just kind of press with my fingers, take a second and let the paint transfer, and then lift. And the process is identical for fabric, although I do probably wait just a smidge longer with fabric. Because it's a different surface, I find that it takes just a moment longer for the paint to actually transfer from the stamp to the fabric. But the process, as you can see, is identical. It's just put it down and press lightly, and I sometimes count to maybe 15 to give it enough time to allow that paint to transfer from the surface of the stamp to the fabric itself. And then it's just a question of lifting straight up, and there you go. So heat setting, as I mentioned a moment ago, is required for permanence on fabric, but it's really not on paper. So this is that piece that you saw in the very beginning. I'm just going to come in and spritz this whole thing with some water, and then I'll grab a piece of paper towel, and I'll just go ahead and put it on here. And you can see that, though it looks like the color's lifting, it's actually not. That was just the color showing through. The paper towel got transparent when it got wet. So you can spray over this. Sometimes, you know, I hear from customers who say, well, I had this background on that I really loved, and then I sprayed through a stencil, or I spritzed something else on it, and suddenly it changed, and it doesn't look nearly as good as it did, or I don't like it nearly as much as I did before I messed with it. So this is an opportunity to put color down in a pattern that you like and have it stay put and not have to worry about it. So that's that. The last thing, let's just come back very briefly to these pieces I did earlier. Let me just get this out of the way. I want to take a moment and just emphasize how well the Fashion Liner works in conjunction with the Textile and the Textile Plus. It doesn't matter if you're working on fabric like what this is here, or if you're working on, this is that original piece of watercolor paper that I went and printed on. So this is the reverse of the stencil. This is what was left after I used the stencil on the gel press plate. I put it on this piece of watercolor paper, pressed it to get that orange and the red to transfer, and then I sprayed through the openings of the stencil, and that's how I got the color in the leaves. So if I want to come in, and of course I'm always going to reach for the glimmery stuff, if I want to come in and use the Fashion Liner, and I'm going to talk about that oozing in 1 second, if I want to do that, then it allows me the opportunity to really emphasize those leaves. So sometimes you'll take the cap off And you'll notice the fashion liner will do this. See how it keeps creating that bubble on there? Let me get this out of the way. What happens is air bubbles. Well, that just scooched out on my finger. But you might get an air bubble inside, and it's gone now. You won't see it, but you'll see it. There's a bubble right here on the top. That air pressure is what's causing the color to ooze out. All you have to do is take the top off and just break that bubble and it will stop, or do what I did, squeeze it out all over yourself and everything's good. So with the fashion liner, you just want to shake to make certain that the product is actually all the way down, and then it's just squeeze and draw. The harder you squeeze, the thicker your line will be. The faster you move the tip, the thinner your line will be. So it's just a question. I always do this on scrap paper first to kind of get my hands warmed up so that they're working. But it's just a question of going ahead and getting the feel for that on scrap paper and then using it. So one of the things that you'll notice is that this looks kind of dimensional. I can assure you that this is not puffy paint. It's nothing like puffy paint. And when this dries, it's going to be perfectly flat, like that piece that I showed you way back in the beginning. And let me bring this in. So this is kind of, this is my original sample done on fabric, and you can see that the fashion liner is perfectly smooth. Even though it goes on and it's kind of in a raised bead, it will smooth out completely when it dries. So Textile and Textile Plus, I want to say between the two of them, there are about 50 colors. I should know that, but off the top of my head, I don't know exactly how many are in each line. But great for use on fabric, obviously heat set for permanence, but also fantastic for use on our kind of paper making things like watercolor paper, Bristol, even sticky back canvas.